Well, hello everyone, and thank you for joining us today on this virtual fall preview day, as I'm going to talk about the Department of Statistical and Actuarial Sciences. My name is Steve Kopp, and I'm one of the faculty members here in the department. I teach mainly actuarial science courses, and so we're going to talk about what our department has to offer and what you as a student or as a parent sending one of your children to Western can expect if they go into the Department of Statistical and Actuarial Sciences. So let's get started on this. So our department, we're part of the Faculty of Science. There's a Faculty of Science symbol, and we offer degrees in four areas: actuarial science, financial modeling, statistics and applied statistics, and data science, and which is a newer program. I think it's in its third year now, statistics, data analytics, and it's combined with the computer science department. And you can either get an honor specialization, which is taking the majority of your courses in one area, and then your option courses on the side, or you can do a major, which is the same number of courses in total, 20 full courses or 40 half courses over your 40 years at Western. But you're taking less required courses and more courses from different areas. And you can do a double major. One of the opportunities of doing a major in one of our areas, you can do a double major, maybe in actuarial science and math or statistics and computer science or something along those lines. So those are things you can consider before you come to Western, or once you're here, actually. We also have a combined five-year program, which combines an undergraduate degree in one of our programs and an honors business administration program through the Iowa Business School. Your first year at Western, all our programs, by the way, don't start till the student's second year. So you're just a first-year general science student. When you apply to Western, you apply for science as ES, and you'll just be a general first-year science student. What you want to make sure you take when you come here is a first-year two-semester course in calculus. The numbers probably don't mean anything to you right now, but you need a first-year two-semester course in calculus and a one-semester course in linear algebra. That'll get you into any of our programs, as long as you have the required grades, of course. Other suggested courses, maybe a first-year economics course is always a good choice. We do have a first-year one-semester course in actuarial science. It's not a requirement for our actuarial program, but you can consider it as an option. Data science is a new course we're just going to be offering this coming September. And so that's something you can consider taking as well. And if you're considering data science as one of the programs you want to go into, or that program you want to go into, you also need the first year, two semester course in computer science. Our department in particular, we offer an internship program. That's where a student after their third year in one of our programs can take a year off school and work for a company in their area of expertise or the area of the program they're in for 12 to 16 months. So that's an option. Say do a co-op program like at Waterloo where you've worked just for 4 months on, 4 months off sort of thing. Here you could go out, and it's usually for a student after their third year, between third and fourth year, but occasionally a student between second and third year can be offered an internship job opportunity. It's not a requirement for the program though. You don't have to do the internship, but it's there if you want to. There's some students who have done it in the past. Notice the suit and tie and nice clothes that they're wearing. Our students are also recruited for summer work term positions. These are 4 month work positions. So we have lots of companies that come on campus to recruit our students, particularly in the actuarial science program. And students can participate in international exchange programs where they can do a semester or two somewhere else. We had a student go down to Australia. We had a few go to Hong Kong, places like that. We don't get that many students involved in this, but it is a possibility. And we do have a student club. It's called the Actuarial Statistical Undergraduate Association, or SUA. And they offer resume writing seminars, interview workshops, networking with industry professionals, professional exam support for those writing actuarial exams. We'll talk about that briefly a little bit later. And so everything's done virtually this year, obviously, like everything else across Canada. But when we get back to normal, whenever that might be, you know, these are face-to-face social events and other business opportunities, or how to write a resume and how to do an interview, that kind of stuff. So all those are possible soft skills that you need to get through life, or sometimes talk to the sewer club. Our department right now, if you're interested, there's one of our hallways in our second floor of the Western Science Center. We have 23 faculty members. Two of them are actuaries. I'm one of them. I'm a full-fledged actuary with a fellowship in the Society of Actuaries and the Canadian Institute of Actuaries. We have 6 faculty joined with other departments and 11 part-time lecturers. And by the way, the 23 faculty members, 2 are actuaries. There's 4 other ones who do research in actuarial fields, may not have the full designation as an actuary, but so we have 6 who are more actuarial related and many who are in financial modeling. And we hired someone just recently who's an expert in data science, and then all the others have expertise in statistics. So we have quite a range of people, faculty our department to help students learn material. We do have about 68 grad students. I know all of you are coming from high school and you're not really thinking about grad school, but there it is. And in terms of about our program, over all the second, third, and fourth year, 365 students in total is what we have. About 212 are in actuarial science, 115 in financial modeling. And those numbers afterwards are the number in first year, second year, fourth year, or sorry, second, third, fourth year. 20 in statistics, and then data science is our newer program. You can see it's growing, 10 that are in second year this year, and 2 who are in fourth year. So let's go finish up our display here, or talking about the different programs that we have. We have 4 of them, so we'll go through them as quickly as we can without doing too quickly. So, I mean, a lot of you are thinking of actuarial science. So what do actuaries actually do? Well, they're professional people who are skilled in the applications of mathematics to financial problems. So that's one of the reasons I went in actuarial science, is that I was good in math, but I wanted to apply my math skills in a business setting. And I worked for a while on the life of Canada, and I'm back here teaching, basically. But actuaries employ their specialized knowledge of the mathematics of finance. So that's interest and bonds and mortgages, loans, stuff like that. Statistics, so a lot of statistics courses actuarial science students take, and risk theory on problems faced by insurance companies, pension plans, employee benefit plans, etc. So actuaries have practical business sense, so you're applying your good math skills in a business setting, so you have to have some business sense. You got to have good communication skills, because you need to convince your colleagues and your clients that what you're doing is the right thing, basically. And what actuaries do is they help people better plan for the future by controlling or basically reducing the financial risks that are associated with retirement, with investing, with getting sick, having your house broken into, a car accident, or dying prematurely, life insurance, that kind of stuff. So actuaries design products both on the individual and group level, like for employers, and at the social level for governments, to help people manage risk and reduce financial risk and give them peace of mind. Where are they employed? About 44% are in the consulting field. That's employee benefits consulting, pension consulting, investment consulting. About 32% in life insurance companies. So in here in London, we have now what's called Canada Life, is one of the big life insurers in Canada. And then property and casualty, which is home and auto insurance, about 6%. Not many in universities, only 1%. I'm in the money for that. And what do they earn? I mean, as a parent, you want your child to go get an education, obviously, and hopefully learn stuff that they can make a career out of and get paid well for it. And actuarial science is one of those. Kind of depends what field you're in, what city you're in, your years of experience, how many SOA, these are the professional exams that you pass or have credit for. But on average, about $114,000 is what actuaries make. Again, some make more than that, some make less. The median is about $105,000. And then by years of experience, so even coming out of university, you can start an actuarial job of $60,000, $65,000, and then work your way up as you get through the exam system and become a fellow of the Society of Actuaries, the Canadian Institute of Actuaries. So, yeah, 20 plus years of experience. The average is about $143,000. So that's not bad. So the earning potential is definitely there. Finally, our actuarial science program, there's our building that we, our offices are located in. We are a center of actuarial excellence as designated by the Society of Actuaries. And we're also been accredited by the Canadian Institute of Actuaries. That's that simple. These are the two bodies that do the education and examination of credentialed actuaries in the United States and in Canada. So being designated a center of actuarial excellence and being accredited by the Canadian Institute of Actuaries just means that our program has been vetted, and it's vetted every year. This is not just a one-time thing, to make sure that we have actuaries on staff, we're teaching the right material, our exams are a strong quality, we have professionals coming in and giving talks, we have research being done in actuarial science. So just basically saying your program is solid. So if a student comes to your school and does an actuarial science degree with your department, they're going to get a good education, okay? And we were not the only ones that fall in this category, but we are designated in both these cases. And by the way, this last one here, this accredited program, just means that some of you might know, to become a credential actuary, you got to write a series of professional exams, just like lawyers have to do their bar exams and our accountants have to do their chartered accountants exam, that sort of stuff. There's a series of exams, but you can get exempted from the first 6. These are the preliminary math ones. If you take the right courses from our university, from our program, and get the right grades, you can get exempted from them. And that will still allow you to work in Canada. Not in the United States, they still want you to write the professional exam. But again, these are things to consider why choosing Western and why choosing actuarial science program here. How about financial modeling? This is a program that's been around about my 15 years now, getting lots of students in that program. You know, we talk about money, Bay Street, you know, the financial district in Toronto, a bull market. It's an interdisciplinary area concerned with the quantitative analysis of financial markets. So quantitative is, got all this risk out there. You know, if you invest money, is it going to go up? Is it going to go down? What does it mean for my portfolio, the pension plan fund that I have? We're trying to put a number, teach you the techniques to be able to put a number to these risks of the financial market. And there's other names that financial modeling could be called that are there. But we call it financial modeling here. Some people call it financial engineering and so on. So what's our goals here? Our program is strong training in traditional quantitative finance. That means fundamentals of financial markets, such as bond market, equity, options, commodities. We teach the mathematical techniques. So we use a lot of stochastic processes and stochastic calculus. And we do computational techniques using the language of R often, and do simulation techniques to simulate what might happen in the future if these certain events occur. So that's Monte Carlo methods. And we tilted our programs to emphasize the statistical and actuarial training increasingly required in risk management and retail credit roles. What that basically means is that some of our financial modeling courses are taken by our actuarial science students and can be used for these credits we were talking about to replace your actuarial exams, or you can use this material in these courses to write the actuarial exams, FM and IFM they're called. Again, those letters may not mean much to you at this stage. Excuse me. Some of our financial modeling programs, second year, have actuarial science and statistics and financial modeling students in it. We make sure we are teaching them for all of those groups. And then statistical techniques are needed by financial modelers as well. Regression, general linear models, that's GLM, time series, all that stuff is taught in that program. And these are some of the companies. There's the big banks in Canada, Bank of Canada, some other ones. And then High Street is one of the top investment firms out there. These have all employed our graduates over the years, and also pension fund management companies, hedge funds, algorithmic trading companies, commodity trading, energy companies, private consulting firms, insurance companies, regulatory institutions like the governments, universities, research initiatives, or institutes rather, hire our graduates. And you can get a degree or get a job with just an undergraduate degree in financial modeling. Same with actuarial science. Forgot to mention that insurance companies, consulting firms, they're not really looking for students with graduate degrees or PhDs. Although if you have that, that's great. But they're happy to get people just undergrad degrees. Same with financial modeling. Although if you want to move up in financial modeling career, you may need a master's degree, but you could get a job with an undergraduate degree. And that's important for parents, especially when you might be footing the bill and then 4 years of university is enough, but you do another one or two in master's program. Now that's down the road. You don't need to worry about that at this stage, but there are job opportunities for financial modeling grads. Okay, our third of four programs is data science. This is our new program. So what is data science or data analytics? It's a buzzword you hear it everywhere in business, engineering, and science, and it refers to new statistical and computational techniques for dealing with large volumes of data, okay? With computing power that we have now and data storage power and space, companies have these large volumes of data. In the past, they wouldn't be able to do much with that other than take a sample of the data. Now they can analyze the whole data, and so they're using these new techniques that are being developed every year, actually, and they're using it to understand their customers, target their marketing better, drive their decision-making, and make better decisions, make more sales, make better profits. That's the idea. And they're using these techniques that you will learn in our data science program. So data science is used in engineering and medical and health and social sciences. I mean, you don't have to take medical science courses or engineering courses in our program. I'm just saying that data science is not just strictly for science and businesses, it's used in all sorts of different disciplinary areas in the world, basically. And data sciences are in short supply in both Canada and the United States, even though it's one of the fastest growing career categories in Canada. So there's lots of opportunities for those who can come out of university, at least with an undergraduate degree in data science, and even better if you have a graduate degree as well. That we're talking about. Yeah, 53% of large Canadian businesses cite talent shortages as the largest barrier for them to completing their big data projects. Here are the skills that you really need to have. Programming in R, which is a free language on the internet. That's a great programming language that you need to learn. Python is another skill that's growing. And all these other data visualization, databases, statistical modeling and inference. Machine learning is big. Artificial intelligence, AI is big as well. And not only all that, but you got all this data. You got to know how to keep it private and not have data leaks and that kind of stuff. That's data governance and privacy. But also in all our programs, not just data science, but the business soft skills side of things is important. You got to be able to be a good communicator, work with other people, do teamwork and work on projects, get them done on time, and then make the right decisions with your data. Ethical and ethical data analysis is also important. So we try to integrate some of these softer skills in our courses throughout your 4 years here at Western. And then there's experiential learning, and that's research opportunities, these summer positions that might be available. The internship, taking a year off school and working are all possibilities in data science and in all our programs, basically. And also there's a lot of our faculty members do research, and then in the summertime, that's when they're doing real hardcore research, and they hire some of our their own students, basically. So that's another opportunity to do a 4-month research opportunity for one of the faculty members in our department. So keep that in mind if you decide to come to Western and end up in data science or any of our core programs. And then TD, Toronto Dominion Bank, gave Western $1 million back in 2018 to set up this TD Analytics Hub, which is a new physical space for collaborative research and problem solving. It's a state-of-the-art classroom. And it's something that if you're in the data science program, you could get into that later on in your career. It wouldn't be in there in your first or second year, maybe in your third and fourth year. So it's just an area where TD really has put their money where their mouth is, saying data science is really important. And there's also a scholarship. We have 4 scholarships a year at $5,000 each to encourage females to get into the STEM, the science, technology, engineering, math. And this is the TD Women in Data Analytics Bursary. So if you come to Western and decide to go to the data science, you could do a Google search for that and say, okay, what's this bursary you was talking about? How do I apply for it? That's something to keep in mind. Finally, we're running out of time here. How about a program in statistics? So what is statistics and how does it differ from data science? This is a discipline that allows us to make sense of data, but it's kind of smaller data sets, not these big giant ones. And again, like the big data or data science, you're trying to look at data and see what is it telling me and what is it not telling me? And it uses math. Again, math is at the core, involves computer programming, so that's very important because all statistical work is done using computer programming. But you have to know the underlying formulas and stuff because, you know, it's one thing to just say, well, this is what the computer told me the answer was, but you got to be able to say, does it make sense? Can I corroborate what the computer said? And so that's why you need to know what the techniques are and the underlying ways things are done. That's what we teach in our program. Here's some of the questions. How do you determine how many fish are in a lake? How can you tell if a medical treatment is successful or not? How should you design an emergency room to get the right patients seen at the right time? How do we better fight forest fires? These are all areas that faculty in our department have done research on and all use statistical techniques. I mean, fish in the lake. I mean, other than catching all the fish and counting them, which you can't do, how do you determine how many fish are actually in that lake? And has it gone down over time due to pollution and things like that? So statistical techniques help you answer these type of questions. Job opportunities, Stats Canada, polling companies who are having a bit of a hard time making predictions for U.S. elections, for example, they've been struggling the last 2 elections. So, I mean, why is that? So polling companies still hire statisticians. Clinical trials, hey, they're doing clinical trials for COVID-19 vaccines. You know, you can't just give it to everybody and hope cross your fingers. You got to do tests and you got to have a placebo group and the group taking the vaccine and then compare the responses. So those are all statistical techniques. Data science companies hire statisticians as well. And again, a grad degree in statistics is probably going to get you a better opportunity for a job than an undergraduate degree in statistics. So, but the undergraduate program here will get you prepared for a graduate program if you decide to go down that route. Okay. So, in conclusion, if math is something you like and you're good at it, you like it in high school, you've always been pretty good at it, but you don't want to go teach it, maybe you don't know what you're going to be able to do with the math degree, but maybe you want to use your math skills in a business setting, then an actuarial science degree or financial modeling or data science or statistics, that is a program for you. All right. My name is Steve Kopp, faculty member in the Department of Statistical and Actuarial Sciences. I thank you for taking the time to watch this, and we'll have time at some point for some questions. Thank you very much, everyone, for considering Western for your kids or you people out there considering Western for your 4-year degree. And that, my friends, is it. Thank you very much.